Hello everyone. Today I will be discussing about non-banking finance companies. Non-banking finance companies are the financial institutions acting as intermediaries between savers and investors. Mutual fund is one of the most popular financial intermediaries. Let us study here mutual funds in details. Now, what is mutual fund? Generally, small investors, they do not have adequate time, knowledge, experience and resource for directly entering the capital market. Hence, they depend on intermediaries, and this intermediaries is called mutual fund. Now, according to the mutual fund fact book published by the Investment Company Institute of USA, a mutual fund is a financial service organization that receives money from shareholders, invests it, earns return on it, attempts to make it grow, and agrees to pay shareholders cash demand for the current value of his investment. So here, mutual fund is a financial service organization. They collect the investment from the small investors and invest it into return on it and grow it into agrees to pay with the shareholders in a cash demand or in the value of in his investment. Now let us discuss the objectives of mutual fund. The first objective here is to mobilize the savings of people. Mobilizing savings for investment, mutual funds serve as a mobilizers of savings of people by offering various schemes. Mutual fund designs various kinds of schemes that meet the requirements of different types of people and divert such savings toward the capital formation. To offer convenient way for small investors to enter into capital and money market. So generally, small investors, they do not have the adequate time and knowledge as we learned in previous slides. So they now allowed to enter into the capital and money market. To tap the domestic savings like household savings and such a savings channelize them into profitable investment. To enable the investors to share the prosperity of the capital market, to act as agents, brokers, intermediaries for growth and stability of the capital market, to attract the investment from the risk averses. Generally, savers are in a fear that how their savings are protective. In such cases, the intermediaries plays very important role and that reduces the risk. So here, mutual funds that attracts the investments from the risk averses to facilitate the orderly development of capital market. It also facilitates to develop the capital market in a nation. Here are some advantages of mutual funds. One, mobilize small savings. Second, diversified investment. Third, provide better returns. Fourth, better liquidity. Fifth, low transaction cost, reduce risk, professional management, offer tax benefits, supports capital markets, promote industrial development, and keep the money market active. Now let us discuss some features of mutual fund. The basic feature is it mobilizes the funds from small as well as large investors by selling units. It also provides an ideal opportunity for small and household investors, an ideal avenue for investment. It also enables the investors to enjoy the benefit of professionals and expert management of their funds. It invests the savings collected in a wide portfolio of securities in order to maximize the return and minimize the risk for benefit of investors. So investors, when they savings their money in the mutual funds, mutual funds offers a wide varieties of portfolios of securities, so that maximizes the returns and it reduces the risk for the investors. It provides switching facilities to investors who can switch from one scheme to another. Mutual funds also provides the investors can switch from one securities or one type of schemes to the another skips. It also offers various types of mutual funds, and it also provides tax benefits to the investors. In India, mutual funds are regulated by agencies like Securities Exchange Board of India. The cost of purchase and the sale of mutual funds unit is very low. It contributes to the economic development of a country. It involves risk subject to the type of risk. We will learn later in detail about the type of risk involved in the different types of investments. Now, types of mutual funds. How the mutual funds are classified? Mutual funds are classified on the basis of operations, on the basis of returns, and on the basis of investments. So here broadly three types of categories are in mutual funds. One, on the basis of operation. On the basis of operation, open-ended and closed-ended fund schemes are in place. Closed-ended funds, under this type of funds, the size of fund and its durations are fixed in advance. The subscription reaches and to the predetermined level, the entry of investors will be closed. So here the size of fund and durations are fixed in advance. Such a type of funds known as closed-ended funds. Features of closed-ended funds. The main objective of closed-ended funds is capital appreciation, because the period and target amount of the fund is fixed beforehand to the investors. Once the period is over or the target is achieved, the subscription will be closed and therefore investors cannot purchase any more number of units. So units is also referred as here as shares. At the time of redemption, the investment is liquidated and the proceeded amount is distributed among the unit holders. Such units are traded in a stock exchange. The closed-ended funds are traded in stock exchanges. Generally, the price of units are quoted at a discount up to 40% below their net asset value. Now, second category, open-ended funds in on the basis of operation types. This is a just reverse of closed-ended funds. Under this scheme, the size of fund and or the period of fund is not fixed in advance. The investors are free to buy and sell their units at any point of time. Now let us see some features of open-ended funds. The investors are free to buy and they can sell their units. There is no time limit bound. There are such as securities are not traded in a stock exchanges. They are not listed in a stock exchange, but units can be sold at any time. The main objective of such a schemes is income generations. Like dividend generations. The prices are linked to the net asset value because units are not listed on the stock exchange. So now let us see what are the difference between these two kinds, open-ended and closed-ended units. The closed-ended schemes are open to the public for a limited period, but open-ended schemes are always open to all the time. Closed-ended schemes will have a definite period of life, but open-ended schemes are transacted in the company. Closed-ended schemes are transacted at stock exchange, whereas open-ended are not transacted. They can easily bought and sold in the company. Closed-ended schemes are terminated at the time of specified period because it is known time and period is known in advance, and open-ended schemes can be terminated only if the total number of units outstanding after the repurchase fall below 50% of their original number of units. Now, second types on the basis of return, or we call as on the basis of income. Here, income fund, this aims at generating regular and periodical income to the members. Such offers are in two types. The first scheme offers earns a target constant income at relatively low risk, and the second offers maximum possible incomes. The features of such income fund schemes are, investors can get a regular income at a periodic intervals, and it is best suited to the old and retired peoples. So generally the retired people and old peoples, their retired money, they can be invested in a such a, and they are in favor of their return will be received periodically as a interval basis or as a regular basis. So for such a people, this is the best suitable scheme on the basis of return, and we call it as an income. The pattern of such investment is oriented towards high and fixed income that yielding securities like bonds and debentures. The main objective of such a scheme is to declare the dividend but not the capital appreciation. It runs only on a short run gains only. Second, growth fund. It offers advantage of capital appreciation, means growth fund concentrates only on a long run basis. But it does not offer regular incomes in case of previous one. But it, in short, growth funds aims at a capital appreciation because it runs in a long run only. And it is also known as nest eggs because it is run on a long runs. Nest eggs investments are long haul investments. The feature of such growth funds are it meets investors' need for only for the capital appreciation and that it runs on a long run. Funds are invested in equities with growth potentials in order to get capital appreciation. It tries to get more capital appreciation by taking much risk. It involves more risk because it runs in a long runs. It may declare dividend, but the main objective of such a type of scheme is capital appreciation. It is best suited for the salaried and business peoples because their income and salary is on the monthly, and business peoples, their salaries are based on the type of their income generated on the particular month or day to day. For such a peoples, this type of scheme is well suited. Conservative funds. It aims for providing a reasonable rate of return, protecting the value of investment and getting capital appreciation. Hence, such a investment made in growth oriented securities that are capable only for appreciating in a long run. Now moving to the third category on the basis of investment. It involves list of number of types of schemes. One, equity fund that consists equity based investments consist high degree of risk. But second, bond fund consists fixed income securities, bonds, debentures, etc., and mainly they concentrate in income rather than capital gains, but it consists low risk. Balance fund, it is a mixture of both above equity and bond, that is debt and equity in the portfolio of investments. The aim of such a scheme is regular income as well as capital appreciation, distributing income as well as capital appreciation. Fourth, fund of fund scheme. In this type, funds of one mutual funds are reinvested in the units of other mutual funds. Taxation fund. This is basically a growth oriented fund. It offers tax rebates to the investors and it is well suitable to the salaried people. So generally salaried people, they are worried about deduction of their tax. To saving their tax, this is the most suitable for salaried people. Leverage fund, index bonds. In this case, the funds are invested from the amounts of mobilized from small investors as well as money borrowed from the capital market. The benefit of leverage to the mutual funds investors is to increase the size of their value of their portfolios. Index bond schemes. They are linked to the specific index of share prices and the securities are included in index concerned in the same proportion. The value of such index linked funds will be automatically go up whenever the market index goes up and reverse, as we call as a vice versa. It may be automatically go up whenever the market index is up or down depend on the market fluctuation pricing. Money market mutual funds. These funds basically open ended mutual funds. They have all the features like first category open-ended mutual funds, but the investment is highly liquidated. They can be converted into the securities, and the securities like commercial paper, certificates, treasurer bills are the types of instruments comes under this kind that we call as a money market mutual funds. Offshore mutual funds. The source of such investments for the funds are from abroad. Such peoples are benefited and such a schemes be known as offshore mutual funds. Guild funds, these are type of funds where funds are invested in a gilt edged securities like government securities, where the funds are not invested in a high level or corporate securities like shares and bonds, etc. To conclude this unit, mutual fund collects the savings from small savers. They invest them in a government and other corporate securities and earns income through interest and dividends beside the capital gains. It is a form of collective investment and it works on the principle of small drops of water make a big ocean. Thank you for patience listening.